What could I say? This Cancrescendo, and this is equipped with a modified EMS drive unit. And yeah, why is this? Why the modification? The standard unit has a rilled paper surround and a usual spider made of some kind of impregnated linen. I don't know exactly what it is made from. And since we knew by experience, listening to old drive units from the years 30 to 40 of the last century, we know that goat leather and phenolic spiders of a special shape gave incredible good results on drive units. We decided, we, Kees Pell, decided to make a trial to this unit to replace the usual surround by goat leather surround and to replace the usual spider by one made of very thin plywood. And yeah, the results were remarkable to our ID. So that's the reason why we, why Kees and me did the job to make a speaker equipped with a unit like this. That's the story about the...
What about the face plug? That's different as well.
Yeah. Yeah, there was a spider original and a kind of a mushroom formed. It looked like a tip, like a shape of a mushroom. A face plug, and yeah, there are always discussions about drive units, wide range units with visors, because a visor is always a little bit problematic. Therefore, we decided to try to remove the visor and to put another a bullet shape face plug. Yeah, and what could I say? To our idea, it is a better solution. There is, of course, less high frequency, but at the other hand, the units to our unit to our ID is a better unit without the whizzer. So, therefore, there is here a little tweeter. And yeah, that is the reason for the bullet plug, for the bullet shaped face plug, and the removal of the whizzer. So, this is to complete the story. Okay. Yeah, unfortunately, in May 2011, my good friend Bernard died. It was a kind of a disaster because the company was closed. And it stayed closed for a rather long time, for half of 1 year, I think. I don't remember exactly. So we had to look for another drive unit. And I was, to be honest, in an earlier date, I was already interested in the field call unit because my friend Kees Pell had a very old unit, only one unit from 1929. And I listened to that unit. It was still in a good condition, and I was very much impressed by the field coil principle. So, and I was asked a few years earlier by Cathy Fertin, the daughter of Michel, if I was prepared to represent them in Holland. And I sent an answer telling her, yeah, sorry, I'm representing V and I want to spend all my energy and time on V. And I think I'm not able to do two things at the same time. And I want to be, I want to promote V because I loved Bernard, I loved the products he made very much. Okay, so we ordered one pair of LB12 units and started experimenting with it in our cabinets. And yeah, for me it was a kind of a revelation. V is very nice, very beautiful, very nice colors, very subtle, but
emotional.
This, sorry?
Very emotional sound.
Yeah, and it was also a unit, one of the only units I listened to in my whole life, which was able to transfer the emotion in the music. And in that aspect, the EMS was in the beginning difficult, different. There were a lot of dynamics, but it was a little bit hard. And so we worked for a very long time to adapt the cabinets and a lot of other things. And after 1-2 years, we had the impression that it was good, and it was a good replacement for V. So that's the story about why we started representing Vetta in Benelux, so in Holland, Belgium, and Luxembourg. And I must say, EMS is a very good, rather small company. I like the approach of Michel and his daughter. They are very kind and willing to help you, and they make very in a good traditional way. They produce their units. They are handmade, and it's paid a lot of attention on it to make it real good. And I like that. It's the old traditional craftsmanship, French craftsmanship. Yeah. I found I think this is difficult to describe. I can only give my personal
when the first time heard it.
Yeah, when I first time listened to I was totally impressed by the presence of the musical instruments, by the dynamic, but yeah, dynamic, that is kind of technical approach, that is not the thing. There was a kind of realism in the reproduction of music. And
this happened at Case House?
The first time it happened at Case House, when I listened to the little 20 centimeter field core unit from 1929. It was listening to it, it was simple. Kees put the unit on the floor without a soundboard or whatever, only the unit. And we were listening to two crescendos with equipped with V KM30 KM30 drive units. And we started listening to the crescendos. And after some time, I asked Kees, please switch on this little field call unit, because I'm very interested to hear what it does. So Kees switched it on, and at that moment we were listening to a record of Frank Sinatra. And it was magical. Kees switched on the unit, and it was just if Sinatra stepped out of the loudspeakers and was present in the room. So I couldn't believe my ears, and I said to Kees, switch it off, let's see what happens. And it went back to the old situation. Nice, very good, but not that feeling of Sinatra is here in the room. So he switched it on again, and the same happened again. And it was, for me, it was a kind of a magic. And that was also one of the reasons why I decided to order the first pair of the LB12 EX field coil drivers from Vetten, from EMS, from electromagnet speaker. Yeah, that was the reason. So, now yeah, and then they came and we mounted them in the standard car crescendo, and yeah, we had the same experience again. Compared to Fee, there was aliveness and feeling of the musicians were in the room, the instruments sounding so natural, so dynamic, so yeah. As you go to a chamber music concert, you can listen the same, you can have the same experience. There is nothing more beautiful than sitting in a nice room and for listening to, yeah, let's say a violin and a cello, violoncello and a piano, and yeah, the same experience I had with the listening for the first time to this cabinets with the EMS units. It was far from perfect, but it was the interesting things were there, the things that really matter in musical reproduction. Okay. Now I want to tell something about the crescendo cabinets as we make it nowadays. The thin panels are still there. This is 4 millimeter saiba wood veneered with organ pine veneer. The rear is different from the original crescendo as we made it a few years ago. This is all wood, plywood cutted by a water cutting machine. Inside the cabinet there's a lot of basing, I shall show it afterwards. The pillar is gone because the front panel is more stiff now. Nevertheless, there is basing on the front panel, as you maybe can see. The front panel is also made of a veneered birch plywood, and the drive unit is mounted on a separate plywood, birch plywood, piece of plywood. The bracing is partially also made of birch plywood, 9 millimeter thick. It is also cutted on a water cutting machine, and so it is much more easy and economic to produce these cabinets. The only thing which has to be done afterwards is to put in the final bracing, and you see here are all little pieces of wood. We know exactly where to put them, but they all have to be put by hand, because it is impossible to assemble the cabinets with these little pieces of wood glued in before. That's not possible. The cabinet is also a resonating cabinet. That's our idea about how loudspeaker cabinets should be made. And this idea is already from the 30s of the last century. The big companies like the well-known companies like Western Electric and others made also a lot of designs with thin walled cabinets, and I shall show you something about what is inside. Here you can see it. You see, it was necessary to put a lot of bracing inside the cabinet, and as you can see, the bracing is put on specific spots. It is not how do you call it, it is not symmetrical. It is found in practice, so it took us several weeks of work to find out how to do this, and the results, for the results you have to come to a listening room and to listen to the loudspeakers. Thank you.